Hi, my name's Melissa. I am from Lansing, Michigan, and I am a reverend and a member of Cedarsong Grove ADF.
And what does that mean? What is ADF?
ADF stands for Arnriach Fane. It is Gaelic for a Druid Fellowship. And what we are is a Reconstructionist religion of Pan-Indo-European religion. And what that actually means is we're not just Celtic. We're actually all of the languages that came from this original Proto-Indo-European language. So that includes the Celts, it includes the Norse, but it also includes things like the Vedics, which is pre-Hindu, and the Avestans, which was the indigenous religion of Iran. So we cover a lot of ground, and we find that that works for us because our symbols are all similar. And so the way we do ritual is the same, no matter which gods we're honoring.
Very nice. And what brought you out here today?
Well, we're here to share what we do at Cedarsong Grove. We've also got a couple of our members who are artists. We have one lady who makes these beautiful hand-dyed scarves. I myself do block prints and paintings. And we have another member who crochets. And so we're hoping to earn a little money for ourselves and also for the American Cancer Society.
Tell me your name and what your organization is.
My name is Stanley Nunn. I am the Reverend of the Pagan Pathways Temple.
And where is that at?
We're going to be opening our doors on September 13th in Madison Heights at 12 and Jenna.
Very nice. And is that in another church or another facility, or you have your own standalone space?
Our own standalone space right next to Mystic Moon.
Okay.
It is a local pagan store. We're moving right next door. Our goal is to bring the different factions of the pagan community together. We've got a lot of different groups in a lot of different areas, and we want to provide a home where anyone of our faith can come and learn and study and find out what they need to find out.
Nice. Now, for somebody who might say, what is a pagan? What do you say to that?
Paganism in general are mostly nature-based religious doctrine. They're groups and organizations who see the divinity in nature and who use nature as a conduit through which we connect to the divine. We see ourselves as a part of nature, and we contribute to its growth and its health, and use that as a way to communicate with the beings that are higher than ourselves.
Nice. So is there any like definitive texts for being a pagan or anything like that? Or
no, we don't have a holy book or anything. Our worship is experiential. We actively seek a connection to the divine and to our creators, and through that search, through experience and ritual and communion, we learn more about ourselves, learn more about our connection to nature, and therefore our connection to our creators.
I am Jackie. I'm part of Michigan Councils of Covenants and Solitaries. I'm one of their board members.
What is that?
Michigan Councils of Covenants and Solitaries is a nonprofit dedicated to the Downriver area, where we help out not just the pagan community, but the community at large. A lot of it is for, like, you know, being in unity. Like, we help out with veterans.
Hi!
He's crashing your interview. Hi, we're doing an interview.
Oh, I apologize.
No, that's okay. Are you with her group, too?
Yes, he's another one.
Are you on the board?
We don't know him.
What's your name?
My name's Scott. Scott Moore.
Scott Moore. What does your group do?
We're with the Michigan Councils of Covenant Solitaires. We're basically as a group to help out the community. We started out last year with a food pantry that helped out several families during the not a food pantry, but
a families
in need campaign. So we've been working to improve that. We finally reached our 501 status, and we're all pretty excited about that.
Thanks. And how long have you been involved with the group?
I've been involved with the group starting back in April. So I'm a brand new member, but we've been done, like, you know, our midsummer picnic. We've been working on, like, you know, we have a public library in the Smoky Crystal, which is a pagan library where we have all, like, you know, pagan-based alternative religious studies and all.
Nice. And what, may I ask, what does your faith mean to you?
My faith means to me is, my spirituality is honestly one of the most important things in my entire life, because I've been a practicing pagan and a practicing witch for 7 years. So I've dedicated pretty much a good portion of my life. Like, it's been difficult due to trials and tribulations, being that it is an alternative path. But at the same time, I feel that it's been really helpful. It's helped me grow over the years, and it's actually, I'm glad it led up to the point for joining the nonprofit, which I'm very, very proud to be a part of.
Nice. Do you think that, there are misconceptions about what it means to be pagan? Do you face that, being that it's sort of an alternative?
Once in a while, but at the same time, like, I've been meeting people who've been very open-minded. Like, they do ask questions. I do get some, like, you know, side jokes and everything, but then I have a tendency of, like, you know, I have a good, well enough education to clear up some misconceptions too, especially the Hollywood type of misconceptions, because I base up off, like, you know, my experience and probably experience of several other people too.
What do you think is, what are some of the misconceptions? Like, what do people...
A lot of it is, like, you know, being like, I'm not just a pagan, I'm also a practicing witch. You know, the whole, oh, do you cast spells, or do you do this or do that? And it's like, yes, I do cast spells, but it's in the same way of the whole long lines of, it's like saying a prayer. You are putting your intentions out, putting it out there, building the energy and sending it out there and manifesting your goals.
So is it more positive than people tend to think it is, or?
It's very positive in my opinion, because it's actually helped me grow, because I actually was a Southern Baptist before, like, you know, I came to be a pagan.
Okay.
And it's a wonderful thing. Like, yes, I've took my family to a while to accept it, but at the same time, I've honestly grown more 7 years as a practicing witch than the first 18 years of my life as a Southern Baptist.
And what made you decide to go down that path? What changed your mind?
When I was about 18, I took up a job at Mackinac Island.
Okay.
And I was there by myself, and, like, you know, I was doing housekeeping and did all kinds of things. But, you know, I started doing researching. It's like, I ran into paganism a couple of years ago as a teen, but, you know, got shot down because of my parents. But
Right. As
soon as, like, you know, I became 18 and moved out of my house, and it's like, I started researching, and it's like, this is what it calls me, especially since Mackinac Island is a beautiful nature base.
Absolutely, yeah, definitely a lot of nature. And what city are you from?
I'm actually from Taylor, Michigan.
Okay. So I can see how Mackinac would be a little bit of a different setting for you.
Yes.
Good. Well, thank you.